Hare Krishna. In 931 of Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, Kauntya pratichani nami bhakti pranashati. My devotee never perishes. Can we be assured Krishna will reciprocate with us, will protect us? He does certainly not favor those who are not his devotees, who are not taking to the path of bhakti. In 9.12, Lord Krishna says, Moksha moha karmana mohyana visheshata rakshasi masrim shiva pragatim moitim shita. Those who are bewildered and attracted by demonic and atheistic views, in that deluded condition, their hopes for liberation, their fruitive activities in their culture of knowledge are all defeated. So these non-devotees, the jnanis who strive for liberation, if there is no tinge of bhakti or love for Krishna or connection with Krishna, they will not attain their goal. And the demons, those who are averse to devotional service, whatever they want to achieve is very temporary. And Krishna says, ultimately, that all their achievements will be baffled at that time. In regards to his devotees, Krishna says, that ananya sintyantam yechna paraparaparastitesam ityabhyuktam yogakshema vamyam. The devotee who serves me with unalloyed devotion, I preserve what they have and I give what they need. Even if we don't achieve perfection in this lifetime, still Krishna will take care of us. In the sixth chapter, he said, one who does good is never overcome by evil. And he explains that when one who practices bhakti for a long time, it takes birth again in a family of pure devotees or advanced transcendentalists, will automatically then become attracted again to the principles of yoga, and make quick advancement to the point they left up last lifetime, and then they can proceed further. So that's Krishna's assurance. He's always with us, he protects us, and we can also see that in the life of Bharat Maharaj. Bharat Maharaj, he became attracted to a deer. Although he became very advanced in yoga, he had attained the stage of bhava. Normally, nobody falls from bhava. This is an extreme example. But still at time of death, he became attracted to, he was thinking of the deer, and he became a deer in his next life. But Krishna gave him what he needed. He gave him remembrance of his previous life. And he, only in the body of a deer, he understood his situation. He went back to the ashram where he was before. And he heard from sages the scriptures, the Bhagavatam. And then next life, he took birth of Jad Bharat. And Krishna gave him again memory of his last two lives. Of course, Jad Bharat and understood, yes, I don't want we have to become entangled anymore in this world. So therefore, Jad Bharat, Jad means mad, he behaved as a mad person, he didn't want to become entangled in anything, and he became self-realized. So that is Krishna's assurance. If we make one step towards him, he makes 10 steps towards us. and he gives us what we need to make further spiritual advancement. Hare Krishna, Jai Prabhupada.